Barbara Vilar, thank you for welcoming us to Overbrook.
Thank you for coming. We appreciate it.
Well, we have this wonderful plan and this beautiful painting of a plan that's going to happen in Overbrook. Can you tell me something about it?
Sure. My company, Valcott Enterprises, purchased the old Overbrook School, which is not far from here. It's right on Route 51. And it was an active school until 2001. And then it became this the administrative offices for special education. And about 6 months ago, they moved out and we bought it. Now, we've had a problem in Pittsburgh with abandoned schools. We all know that we have school buildings that are closed and nobody does anything with them. Mm-hmm. We bought this because we want to make this a senior housing campus. So we are going to take the school building, which is up in the corner, and we are going to convert that to a 91-bed personal care home.
Wonderful.
And we are also going to have a therapy center, because one of the things that is near and dear to my heart is making sure that seniors have as much functionality as possible for as long as possible.
And that's wonderful.
And of course, the traditional thing that happens is the seniors at home, or they're in an apartment or whatever, and they fall and they break a hip.
Right.
And they never recover and they end up in nursing homes.
Mm-hmm.
Now, I'm a licensed nursing home administrator. I've administered nursing homes. I don't want to end up in a nursing home.
Me either.
And I don't want any of my residents there. So the first thing you have to understand is that fall doesn't come out of nowhere. There are falls that precede that. They may not get hurt, but they're warning signs. So we want to emphasize therapy as a way of intervening early so that we can prevent as many of those catastrophic falls as we can.
Beautiful.
You know, we can't prevent them all, but we're going to try that. We also will have a dining room.
Okay.
And we are going to emphasize healthy food that tastes good. And believe it, you can have the same.
You can't have
you
one
can
of the same.
You can't have one of the same. Yes, indeed. So that's what we're going to do with the school building. Now, we've partnered with a group called NRP Group,
mm-hmm.
and they are the largest developer of affordable housing in the country. They're a top 10 multifamily housing developer in the country. And they have an agreement with us, contingent upon obtaining senior housing tax credits, to build a 50-unit independent living on what are now some abandoned baseball fields.
Okay.
Okay. And so we're going to have plenty of parking. But the other thing we're going to do is this road is new.
Okay.
Okay. We're going to put a new road in. This is actually, it's shown as green space, but it's actually where DeCarlo's Pizza and a car lot is. We're not going to change that.
Okay.
But we're going to put a new road in. And what we're going to do with the road is we're going to put in two things. For the community, we're going to put something right here, and that's what we call a kiss and ride. And it's a drop-off spot,
no.
So people can come in
yeah.
from the community, drop off, pick up their folks who are using the T. And we're also going to dedicate these 10 parking spaces to the community. We know that they probably need more, but mm-hmm. we have our own parking needs. But we're going to really try to accommodate the community as much as possible. There's actually right now a walkway. There used to be a walkway there. It's now covered in dirt, but we're going to restore the walkway and put a bridge over to the South Bank T stop, which is a wonderful T stop.
Mm-hmm.
Both the bus and the T stop there.
Right.
And nobody can get to it.
But from that stop, you can get anywhere you want to
absolutely.
In the city.
Absolutely. So anybody who lives in either the independent living or the personal care is just a few hundred yards from transit.
Okay.
So they can go to South Hills Village.
Mm-hmm.
They can go downtown.
Downtown.
They can go to the casino.
Anywhere they
yeah. PNC Park. Exactly. And one of the things as a long-term care person, my most immobile resident is the resident with a mechanical wheelchair, motorized wheelchair,
mm-hmm.
because you can't just throw that in the back of your car, right?
Right.
You have to have the special platform. Well, the T accommodates motorized wheelchair. So I have this dream, you know, of looking out the window of my office one day and seeing, a bunch of my residents headed for the T, and they're all lined
that's
up.
Very beautiful.
And people say, well, where are they going? Well, 4th of July sales at South Hills Village.
Mm-hmm.
4th of July sales downtown.
Going to see the fireworks downtown.
Yeah, going down.
Enjoy the regatta.
Absolutely.
Well, that's
baseball
wonderful.
Game.
Baseball game. That's wonderful because I've got a real sense that Overbrook is a community. And a strongly knit community.
Mm-hmm.
And now you're adding this extra element so that not only people are going to be able to come in to see people, but
right.
you've got your folks going out to other parts of the community.
Right. Well, the other thing is there'll be 50 full-time jobs with benefits at the personal care home. So our community will welcome the jobs.
Right, right.
And the other thing is we have a lot of seniors in this community who want to stay here because right. it is a strongly knit community. Mm-hmm. But they are in apartment houses. If you take a look at the apartment houses on Brownsville Road, a lot of them were built at a time where they're all steps. So they'll live on the second or third floor, and they have no elevator, so they get stuck in their apartments. Mm-hmm. So what I'd love to see is have them come down to either independent living or personal care, but then I'd like to get some young, healthy folks who can climb those steps mm-hmm. to come move into those apartments and hopefully come down and take a job.
Wonderful. I love it. So I was going to say, well, where do you see Overbrook in 25 years? I already see it. I don't even have to ask the question. I see this.
But this is what we want to have as a signature development on Route 51. Because right now, if you talk to somebody about developing on Route 51, you'll hear all about it's a floodplain, it's blighted. But if we can develop, then the next question becomes, why can't you do it again?
Right.
And that's a real different question.
Absolutely.
So I want to see our development, but I want that to be the start.
Yeah. To kickstart every other.
Right. And I want to see lots and lots of development on Route 51. It's close to the city. We have good, solid, hardworking people here. Mm-hmm. Any employer who wants to employ our people would be glad to have us.
How long have you lived in Overbrook?
I actually live on the border of Carrick and Overbrook.
Uh-huh.
Okay, but my family built, I live in a 4-unit apartment building. My family built it in 1958.
Wow.
And my parents actually, I grew up in Greentree, but I visited every weekend.
Mm-hmm.
And then when my aunt and uncle died, I took over in the late 90s. So I'm a proud, proud resident of Carrick and Overbrook.
Mm-hmm.
I've worked here and I know the folks here. And like I said, we need employers and development to come here because we have a workforce that we can get the job done and anybody would be glad to have us as employees. So come in, give us some development and we'll do the rest. Let us show you what we can do.
Well, I was going to ask you about local heroes, but I think you're a local hero. You are definitely a local hero. I want to thank you for having us in your neighborhood. I want to say this is, to me, is so inspirational.
Thank you.
It should inspire other neighborhoods. I was going to ask you, what neighborhood in Pittsburgh inspires you and why? But I think that you, your neighborhood, and you are an absolute inspiration to other neighborhoods.
Well, thank you. And actually, one of the things that Valcott is committed to doing is expanding to other sites. So you may see us in your neighborhood at some point.
Wonderful. Wonderful. Well, thank you for having us.
Well, thank you.
And I'm going to be looking forward to seeing this.
Well, I'm going to be looking forward to seeing Talk Pittsburgh back at the ribbon cutting and interviewing my residents.
All right. I think you could probably get a deal on that one.
All right. Thank you.